Well, good morning, everyone. It's Thursday, and I'm so glad you tuned in. And I hope you're enjoying the trip that Diane and I celebrated our 50th wedding anniversary during to the Northwest. And we've sure enjoyed being a part, having you be a part of it. It's almost over now, but a couple more days. Now, I'm coming to you again today from Lake Tahoe. Look at all the people swimming. I'll move my head. It's none, isn't it? Of course, I just got out of the water from swimming. Just kidding. No, that water, the temperature is 42 to 46. I guess it varies, but that's what they tell me. So I know it comes as a surprise, but neither Diane nor myself will be swimming on this trip. We did have an encounter with water, though, again. On our way to Lake Tahoe, we stayed overnight in a small town called Burney, California, B-U-R-N-E-Y. And Burney is about a 3,000 population, and it had some nice things, but the one thing it does have is right by it is a place called Burney Falls. And I will show you that in just a minute, because these falls are very beautiful. In fact, they say that years ago, Teddy Roosevelt came to this area, and he said that Burney Falls, of all things, was the eighth wonder of the world. Now, they're nice falls, but I'm not wondering, did Teddy Roosevelt not go to Niagara Falls or some of the other amazing ones around the world? So anyway, I'm going to show you in just a moment, but let me share with you Isaiah 58:11, which is going to be our verse for today. And it says, "The Lord will guide you always. He will satisfy your needs in a sun-scorched land and strengthen your frame." But here's the part that I want as our verse for the day. "You will be like well-watered garden, like a spring whose waters never fail." You will be like a spring. In other words, you will be vibrant and have freshness about you. And that, you know, it's interesting. And it says, like a spring whose waters never fail. The Lord uses water and springs all the time to be a picture of how our life can be. Isn't that amazing? Sometimes we don't feel like that, do we? I'm going to talk about that in a while, but for right now, let me just show you for about 1 minute video that I shot of Burney Falls. I'm going to play the sound of it too, because for me, the sound of it is just as refreshing as the view of it. I just think those falls, waterfalls in general, are just spectacular. Remember the frustration of the waterfalls that we talked about last week? Hope you were watching. I just couldn't find any that we could actually get up to, but Burney Falls, we did. Let me just give you a couple quick facts about those falls that you saw. They're 129 feet in height, top to bottom. The depth of the pool is 22 feet, and the water temperature is in the 40s. 100 million gallons of water per day flow over Burney Falls. I thought, you know, that is really neat, the way that the Lord gives us such things of beauty as waterfalls. I actually found we did take from the road a couple pictures of a couple other waterfalls, and I'll put those up briefly. But I didn't get any facts. I couldn't stop. I just love waterfalls, though. I think most people do. Burney Falls is a gift of God. Now, why does God give water as an illustration of the freshness of life and the renewal of life? And it's so, you know, even in Psalm 23, I walk beside still waters. And in Psalm 1, it's like a tree. You'll grow as you meditate in God's word. You'll grow like a tree that's planted by springs of water. God loves, I think water, and even just like this. I'm sorry that there's so much smoke around that you can't see all the beauty of Lake Tahoe. But God always uses that, or often uses water and the springs, as illustrated, I think, by waterfalls. You will be like a well-watered garden, like a spring whose waters never fail. That's a tremendous promise of God, especially if you're like me. I mean, I've got some aches and pains and things that I didn't have a month ago. And it just seems like, the more mature we get, the more of these aches and pains, or even more serious than that, things happen to us. But someday, we'll be like a well-watered garden, like springs that just keep flowing. That's for us. Now, that's the promise of God. What if it's not happening right now? Does that mean that the promise of God is null and void? Of course it does not. One of two things is happening. One, another season of your life might happen soon. That if we have an ailment, it may well be healed. And sometimes it's healed through operations. And then we feel good again. God uses doctors to renew us and bring us more like the springs again. But for many of us, it's the second thing. And that is that God will fulfill this promise in the future. And that future is often in heaven. That, you know, we read in Revelation 21 that we'll have no more pain, no more sorrow. Our bodies are renewed. We've been promised that just like Jesus' new body was perfect when he was raised from the dead, just like for us, when we're raised from the dead or we pass from this life into the next, our bodies will not have the pains and suffering that we currently have. This promise of God is absolutely true. We will be like a well-watered garden, like a spring whose waters never fail. That's in our future. And I hope you allow this beautiful waterfall to be a symbol of that in your life. Well, God bless, and I'll see you tomorrow. We have another great show in store for all of us. Have a great day of walking with him. Bye for now.